great lineup. Today is our day to talk to you as an executive. With that, I'm out. You're listening to IBGR, our call sign for the Internet Business Growth Radio Network. The broadcast frequency is our URL, and that's IBGR.network. We provide live and recorded shows 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, on what an entrepreneur or small business consultant needs to grow their operation from zero to big. How big? Up to you. IBGR focuses on the 180 million English-speaking small business owners around the world in four major markets: North America, Australia, Oceania, the Indian subcontinent, and United Kingdom, Europe, and Africa. All of these six-hour cycles are delivered in six major themes: strategy, operations, sales, people, ownership, and consulting. The first four tracks, strategy, operations, sales, and people, are the day-to-day tactical issues all entrepreneurs face. The fifth track, ownership, takes the conversation to the next level. How can an owner working in the business make the transition to an executive of a multi-million dollar firm by working on it? Our last track, consulting, is for our brothers and sisters with the same mission as IBGR, helping small business owners grow. I bet you didn't know that 57% of everybody on the planet is employed by a small business owner. Let's team up and help business owners increase generational wealth for themselves and their family while creating good jobs in their local community. Our team has over seven decades of helping and building businesses. We have turned those years of experience into radio shows and downloadable tools that any entrepreneur, whether you're an independent contractor, solopreneur, or business owner, can apply immediately. All you have to do is download, listen, apply, and engage. Download the show notes that address current issues in your business. Listen to the show live or as a podcast. Apply the information and tools. Engage us with your experience and feedback. And if you really want to maximize your time spent with IBGR, join our community and have access to our toolbox. This just scratches the surface of what you will receive every day at IBGR. The opportunity to grow with us is only limited by your imagination and persistence. Let's grow together and put the world back to work. Thanks for listening.
To Women of Business Thriving on the IBGR Network. I am your host, Dr. Tracy Hines-Lashley, and I am excited to be here with you today. Last week was a time where I did not think that I was going to have to, you know, not show up like I normally do because I was a little ill. And so one of the things I love to do is make sure that I am on point, on time, and about my business. So it required me to do a little bit of pivoting. And I will tell you, I'm great today. I'm back. I am excited to be here again. Well, I'm always excited. So one of the things I want you to really do before we get started is download the app. Yes, IBGR has an app. So whether you have an Android or an iPhone, you can download it. And I am excited about this app. One reason is because I'm always on my phone. We always have our phone in our hands. So to be able to click on one button, see everything that we have to offer, and get into the site is amazing. So do that for me, and also have pen and paper ready because you're going to want to take a lot of great notes. So what is this thing about women of business thriving? I'm always about teamwork and collaboration and communication and also leadership. So one thing that you want to make sure that you have the right mindset when you're solving problems and you have the right people in the room. And you're going to always hear me talk about teamwork. That is something that will never leave, no matter which topic that I am discussing. So a little bit about me before we get started. I am the Chief Elevation Officer for the Leaders Innovative Growth Solutions, LLC, and I am also the CEO of a nonprofit for women, Bossed Up Lead Hers Incorporated. We are a 501c3 corporation. This is where I wanted to change the show for women. I'm out here educating women all the time. And I'm like, well, why am I not doing it on the business aspect? So I was like, okay, world, get ready. We are going to have a show for women. And I'm loving it. And one of the things I want to do, I want to hear from you. Are there any topics that you want me to discuss? Do you want to be on the show? Because guess what? You can be. I would love to have you on the show. You know, talking to other women about your issues, your challenges, your wins. One thing we don't do enough is talk about our wins. It is not boasting. It's, you know, showing others that, hey, we can show up and show out and win in this world. We can dominate. And that's an aspect that I love. I love seeing women win. Men, I'm not saying I don't love to see you win, but it's all about the women on my show, okay? So another thing that I am, I'm a DISC certified consultant and trainer. And also recently, an emotional intelligence certified trainer, coach, and consultant. So we have to always think about our emotional intelligence, even in business. I did a show on this. So if you didn't, you know, catch that show, go and listen to the recording, which is a podcast. Where can you find it? On the app, of course. So we need to ensure that we understand this. It's not just for personal. It's also for business. And another thing I discussed is, matter of fact, no, go back and download the app. I want you to go and see all the shows that you actually missed. So I'm not going to tell you everything. I want you to download this app and go into the community and communicate with me, chat with me and others, and tell us what you think. So as women, we need to be ready for business. We need to be dominating because we can. We need to show up, like I said, because why? We are so underrepresented in a lot of industries, in a lot of areas. One thing I can say is I have a cousin who is in construction. Yes. And when I tell you she is like dominating in Georgia, she is. And also she has extended out to Florida. So seeing her following our grandfather's footsteps. Now, she didn't start there. Not by all means. She was in the government system for years, retired as a budget analyst. And now she's doing construction. So when I tell you we can do anything we set our minds to, ladies, yeah, we can. So today's show, we're going to be talking about problem solving. Why is this important? See, this is a show I wanted to do last week, but because I was ill, it didn't happen. You know, as entrepreneurs, sometimes that happens, but hey, it's okay. I'm here and we're going to discuss it because this is a crucial aspect of your business. A lot of us steer away from solving problems when we shouldn't. So one of the things I want you to think about is what problem are you running away from? Because you don't really know how to solve them. Do you even know what a problem is? If you don't, it's okay. Because why? I'm going to tell you what it is later on the show. But every problem you have is a seed of its own solution. If you don't have any problems, you don't get any seeds. Norman Peel said that. So, can we boast of spending a day with no problems at all? I doubt you can. Is it impossible? We face problems every day, every hour, every quarter. I am telling you, you are solving problems and not even realizing it. Because you might be doing it on the fly. And you're thinking, hey, I'm solving this problem, so it's okay. But is it really? And are you solving the right problems? You know, as business owners, entrepreneurs, we are always thinking that we have all the solutions. Hey, I have this problem. I can do it alone. No, you can't. You cannot do it alone. You need your team with you. They need to always be with you. So problem solving skills is extremely important because your business has to survive any problem that you have. And also the entrepreneur journey is riddled with ups and downs. Now, if you tell me you didn't have any downs in your entrepreneurial success, you may not be an entrepreneur, okay? And why am I saying this? Because in life, there are ups and downs. And the same in business. You can't tell me you've always been up. You have to grow. You have to excel. In order to do that, you got to take a step back and look at the problems you've had in the past, as well as making sure they don't happen again, or having processes in place. And I talk a lot about processes, procedures, and also having the right strategies. So if you have missed those shows, I'm going to say it again, go download the app because you don't want to miss out on that juice. You're going to want to go back and listen. And another thing is, you know, my problem solving skills, it developed and improved over time. It was not something that I went to school for and said, hey, okay, I have all the book knowledge in the world. I can go out here and just conquer the world. Nah, it did not happen that way. So yes, I am a doctor in organizational leadership and management, but it just taught me the foundation. So what you're getting on the IBGR network, you're getting real world experiences from people who are doing it every day. We're telling you what we know, not just what we read in a book. Yes, we're bringing in some of that knowledge, but you need us to keep growing. And I'm here to keep growing. I will never stop learning. And that is what the IBGR network is providing you and me and all of us. A network where we're not going to be stale. We're not going to just be stagnant and not grow anymore. I'm telling you, I learn from listening to other people on this show, on this station, and it is amazing. So what I want you to do is not think that because you read something somewhere on problem solving that you know how to solve all these problems, because you can't. You have to actually implement. You actually have to do the work. And I'm going to talk a lot about creative problem solving as well. So 7 reasons that people don't solve problems that they should be solving. They don't realize what's expected. They're not confident. And it's easier to ask you to solve it. I just, hey, pass it over here and tell somebody else to solve this problem for me. That's not always a good thing. Even though I talk about teamwork, having someone do it for you is not always good. And it's easier to have someone else solve it for you. And also, you know, the thinking, you know, has to be stretched. A lot of us don't want to stretch our thinking. So we don't want to solve these, you know, these tough problems. We just pass along. And people don't appreciate the significance of the problem. Yeah, you have to embrace it, embrace that bigger picture. And you also don't care enough about it. And we're going to dig deep into that one as well when we come back. And they also don't have the capability for that role. Yeah, that's a big one. So we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to dig a little bit deeper into problem solving. We'll be right back.